Rabbinical Alliance to be able to host, in his initial foray into the Orthodox Jewish community, the person who I believe, from a spiritual perspective, not only is he gaining the polls electorally, but from a spiritual perspective, I can almost guarantee Mr. Palladino and many rabbis here, he can be and will be, God willing, if he sticks to the values, he will be the next governor of the state of New York, and it's an honor to have him. Palladino to address us briefly, never used the words referring to Sheldon Silver. He never initiated terminologies referring to Silver as a Hitler or an Antichrist. He commented on something that was said by a county supervisor of Erie County. Mr. Palladino, in his rough and tough way, might have expressed a feeling that many of us in the Orthodox have, in the community have, with regard to Sheldon Silver. We abhor the baby killing, that Mr. Silver has sanctioned up until and including cutting off debate at 2 o'clock in the morning on partial birth abortion, not even allowing the liberty of decent religious family legislators to speak out. So I'm saying here today that many of us have for years looked at Mr. Silver as a person who licenses wholesale baby killing, and I say, and many Orthodox Jews, and many religious Christians, and many decent normal people, like Pat Moynihan, who said, Senator Moynihan said, this is not abortion, I support abortion, he said, this is killing. Eddie Koch, the liberal's best friend, took apart Sheldon Silver in the New York Post column for being a baby killer, okay? So we agree on that. Furthermore, Sheldon Silver's endorsement and embrace of same-gender marriage, the thing that we know caused the last step before the floods of Noah that actually destroyed the world according to our tradition, this is an outrage. So I don't think we have to use terms like Hitler or Antichrist. He's a baby killer. He's a betrayer of our religious convictions. And for too long, the sycophants in our own community, like the disgraceful display yesterday on the steps of City Hall, where people went, and I must say we're big boys, Dov Hyken, so I love you and you love me, we can talk, but I'm calling you out, Dov Hyken. Where do you have the nerve to incite people the way you did? To say, Hitler started off his political career and people said, no, he's not serious. I'm not comparing, he said, Karl Palladino to Hitler. This is the way a street thug talks, Mr. Hyken. You're a nice guy, I love you, though. I love you. That's what liberal Democrats say. As long as you sandwich your criticism and I love you, it's okay. So I'm saying we were embarrassed. The Politico, Maggie Haberman, Politico, I wish I would have that paper, she called them, before they even got down to City Hall, she called them Cuomo's surrogates. Cuomo's surrogates. And I'm happy to say that the people understood, thank you very much, I'm happy to say that people understood exactly what that disgraceful display was. And I told the rabbis and community leaders there, I told them to their faces that for too long, George Weinberger and Agudath Israel, let's give them the honor that they wanted by standing for the photo op, David Niederman of Williamsburg from the UJO. For too long, I said, did you bother to sit down with Mr. Palladino and do a little bit of research to find out he never even said it? You know that Cuomo's people did opposition research and found this in a Niagara paper several months ago, maybe a half a year or 3 quarters of a year ago. So why is this suddenly coming up now? And I have a public request of Andrew Cuomo. Andrew, and I say this apologetically and with respect, but I'm almost a senior citizen. And I remember as a New Yorker in around 1977, when Mayor Koch became mayor for the first time. And in that campaign, they sat in the inner sanctum of Cuomo and developed something called vote for Cuomo and not the homo. And Ed Koch had to run around, as he writes in his book, with Bess Meyerson, former Miss America. You don't want these tactics in the campaign. Do not use surrogates in my community to excite interreligious tensions falsely. If you, Andrew Cuomo, feel that this man, Carl Palladino, is an anti-Semite, then Andrew, come out of the closet and say so, and let's explore it. Stop sending the Dove Hikins and the George Weinbergers and the David Niedermans to say these things. It's disgraceful, it's offensive to our community. And I want to say that a new era has dawned. Because I'm saying here today that when these liberal hacks to get a few shekels or breadcrumbs from the table of the deviance lobby, when they are going to make press conferences, ostensibly speaking in the name of the Orthodox Jewish community, while spitting on our values, I asked them, when was the last time they made a press conference when Sheldon Silver pushed partial birth abortion, baby killing, or homosexual marriage? I didn't see them at a press conference. I'm telling you, we are going to go down there, and I'm not going to be polite next time. Next time, we will interrupt their press conference wherever it is, because this is too important, the future of our children. And our values, it's too important to be left to the left-leaning losers of the Orthodox community who are selling our heritage and our godly values for a bunch of lentils, shekels, and pottage. No more. We don't want it. Carl Palladino is the arising of a new era. That's why we're embracing him. That's why New York State, far beyond the context of the Orthodox Jews, I promise Mr. Palladino, if he sticks to this return to religious and civil values of decency, if he understands and educates and informs the community that we are not merely opposed to the deviance for spiritual reasons, though that's far than more enough, we're opposed because we don't want to become constituted as legal bigots and racists, lose our tax deductions, be forced to embrace any deviance that the politically correct crowd decides to throw at us. So without further ado, I want to present to you the next governor of the state of New York, Mr. Carl Palladino.